हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज आवर, दिस इज द पार्ट एट एंड सम साल्ट। बाय यूजिंग अ मेथड वी कैन प्रिपेयर दी साल्ट्स। सो नेक्स्ट साल्ट इज लेड क्लोराइड। ओके, लेड क्लोराइड दैट मीन्स द PbCl2। द मेथड ऑफ फॉर्मेशन इज द व्हेन द लेड नाइट्रेट रिएक्ट विद द NaCl, एक्वस NaCl, here aqueous ion, that means the liquid when NaCl dissolve in the water. Okay, so such type of solution is known as the aqueous solution. So when the lead nitrate react with the aqueous solution of NaCl, get converted to the lead chloride and NaNO3. Like this, this is the beaker. In this beaker we take the lead nitrate and aqueous solution of NaCl. By using the glass rod we stir it after the reaction, it converted to the precipitate of the lead chloride. After the filtration, after this, the next step is the filtration of the solution. We reduce the filtrate, the lead chloride, and after the lead chloride, we take the angina disc and leave the 1 or 2 days for the crystallization. After the crystallization, it get converted into the crystalline lead chloride. Okay, now next salt is preparation of the sodium bicarbonate. This is also known as the baking soda. For the formation of the baking soda, we can use the sodium carbonate. This is known as the washing soda. When the sodium carbonate, aqueous solution of sodium carbonate pass through the carbon dioxide. When carbon dioxide pass through the solution of the aqueous solution of sodium carbonate, it convert into the sodium bicarbonate. This is known as the sodium bicarbonate. It is also known as the baking soda. Like this, if we take a conical flask and use the cup, here two tubes are there. In by this tube, we enter the carbon dioxide in this flask, and sodium carbonate already in this flask. And here put it with the ice, that means no heat required, because this reaction is the exothermic reaction. So in the on cooling with the ice, sodium carbonate react with the carbon dioxide gas and get converted into the sodium bicarbonate. After this we use the filtration process. After the filtration we use the crystallization process, and in final we can prepare the crystalline baking soda. Okay, now next topic is our hydrolysis of the some salts. So there are overall total 4 types of the salt. First type of salt by prepared by the weak acid and strong base, like this NaCN. NaCN can prepare by the NaOH and HCN. HCN is the weak acid and NaOH is the strong base. When the NaCl on the hydrolysis, it gets converted into the NaOH plus HCN, and it is also produce H plus and Cl minus. So Cl minus dissociate on the hydrolysis process and get converted into the HCl and OH minus. Look, in this case we get the strong base, so that is why the solution will be, the pH of the solution is greater than the 7. So this is the basic solution. Okay, now next, strong acid and strong base. The salt which are made up by the strong acid and strong base. Strong acid and strong base like this, NH4Cl. NH4Cl made by the NH4OH and HCl. Look this, this is the strong acid. Look this, it is the weak base, it is weak base. After the reaction of neutralization, we get the NH4Cl. So when NH4Cl on the hydrolysis of NH4Cl, it gets converted to the NH4OH and HCl. This is the strong base and the formation of HCl. So that is why this solution is acidic in nature. That means the pH value of this solution is less than the 7. And when the NH4OH get the radical NH4 plus ions all go through the water molecule on the hydrolysis and get converted into the ammonium hydroxide. It is the weak base. So you know very well the acid is strong, so this solution will be acidic. Okay, now next, strong acid and strong base. Now third type of the salt, like NaCl, KNO3, KCl, these type of the salt are known as the strong acid and strong base. That in the neutral salt, they do not show the hydrolysis. Okay. Now next, weak acid and weak base. The salt which can form the weak acid and weak base. So NaCl, CH3, so ammonium acetate and ammonium cyanide. And when ammonium cyanide and ammonium acetate go through the hydrolysis and produce the solution and give through the both are the weak acid and weak base. When the both weak acid and weak base, look this NH4CN, this is the salt. On the on the hydrolysis of the NH4CN, it get converted to the ammonium hydroxide and HCN. Ammonium hydroxide is a weak base. It is weak base and it is weak acid. So weak acid and weak base both are having the almost same pH value. That is why pH value will fluctuate more than 7 or less than 7 or equal. So most probable is the pH value is approximate 7. That is why this solution will be the neutral. So this is the process of the hydrolysis of the salt. In next topic, we will discuss the water crystallization and some other factor. Okay. Okay. Now after this, next topic is water crystallization. You know very well what is the water crystallization. The water molecule which is enabled in the crystal, that is known as the water crystallization. The proper definition is this: fixed amount of the water molecule included within the structure of the molecule of the crystalline substance. Like this, this is the formula of the plaster of Paris, CaSO4, H2O, yani ki hemihydrate. So this is known as the water of crystallization. Like this, this is the plaster of Paris, gypsum. In gypsum molecule, two molecules are known as the water of crystallization. Like this blue vitriol, five water molecules known as the crystallization of the water. Okay. Now next topic is fluorescence. What is the fluorescence? The phenomena in which the crystallization hydrated water crystallization hydrated when exposed to the air, then the water molecules which is inbuilt in the molecule get exposed to the air. Okay, that means when the water molecule come through the hydrated salt, that is known as the effervescence. This phenomenon is known as the effervescence. Like an example, suppose CaSO4 5 water molecule in this crystal on exposed air, dry air, it can convert into CuSO4 and 5 water molecule. You know very well this crystal is blue color and it convert into the white anhydrous copper sulfate. Is that clear? Blue crystal converted to the white crystal. Now next, last topic of the chapter is deliquescence. What is the deliquescence? Those substance which absorb the water molecule from the air. So such type of the substance are known as the deliquescence. This is the definition, the phenomena in which the water soluble substance on exposure to the atmosphere at the ordinary temperature absorb the moisture from the air. So such type of the substance are known as the deliquescence. Like this, zinc chloride, anhydrous zinc chloride, get water molecule, absorb the water molecule from the moisture. So those substance which can absorb the moisture from the air, so such type of the substance are known as the deliquescence. Okay students, this is the last topic of this chapter. In next video we will meet with the new chapter. Okay, thank you for watching.